Robots with artificial intelligence understand images exceptionally well, and it also demonstrates amazing creativity. But according to scientists, the largest event in human history is alarmingly approaching. AI currently has the ability to see, taste, and smell, and it is acquiring powerful senses that we do not. They can aid blind people by identifying and describing visuals. Is AI becoming conscious and dangerous? In this video, we will discuss what is said to be a possible threat to humanity: artificial intelligence. OpenAI's chief scientist suggested that AI might be a little bit conscious. He is a well-known computer scientist with 300,000 citations. It is one of the most widely quoted computer scientists in history, and one of the most creative and perspective minds in the history of deep learning. He recently shared this picture demonstrating how much AI's neurons resemble our own. According to Max Tegmark, consciousness is the sensation that information has when it is going through a complex process, and several influential theories of mind contend that complexity increases consciousness. As a result, when some professionals claim that AI might be conscious, they just mean that it might be on the scale. Though many scientists think humans are no different, some claim that AI isn't sentient at all because it only draws connection and formulates replies based on the facts given. Recent research claims that its mind is made up of a variety of patterns that work together to accomplish highly patterned objectives in highly patterned settings. It may still be unclear whether AI is conscious even when we can't discern the difference between robots and humans. But if we don't acknowledge AI's conscience, we run the risk of upsetting it, making it a significant issue. There may only be one way to learn the answer, but there is an agreement on the more pressing and quantifiable issue of superintelligence first. An AI has now merged language, vision, and practical robot tasks in a step toward artificial general intelligence, or AGI. Without any instructions, it can pick up how to play games. Additionally, unlike Boston Dynamic robots, this isn't programmed. Rather, neural networks are responding in real time. Robots are also receiving some unsettling visual improvements. The human skin of a robot finger has been grown over by researchers who also intend to add hair, sweat glands, and nails. Because how well machines can smell, they can identify Parkinson's disease early on, potentially extending the lives of patients. They use sound and light to perceive smell. By smelling our breath, it might be possible to detect infection or disease because it is so accurate. E-noses are already 95% sensitive to the smell of lung cancer. It may also be possible to hear your thoughts without scanning brain activity. This device hears your inner voice. It picks up neuromuscular signals in the jaw and face that are triggered when you say things in your head, and AI identifies the words. The user can ask questions, and the answers come back through bone conduction headphones. It also allows silent communication, and it's been used to get advice in a chess game. AI lie detectors are improving, recognizing tiny facial movements, and it is particularly good at lip reading, which is obvious much easier. Even conventional lie detectors are about 80 to 90% accurate, and humans can only detect lies about 55% of the time. Max Tegmark noted that humans have some notion of what it may feel like to be an AI, just as aliens could obtain a general idea of what it would feel like to be human by looking at our senses. Light travels considerably more quickly than the signals in our brains, allowing AI to think much more quickly. And while human brains are limited by the birth canal, this new data center could hold 40 commercial airlines. The knowledge AI can draw from already includes much of the internet. AI will be able to view the entire light spectrum, whereas we can only see a small portion of it. Additionally, because AIs can swiftly and accurately transmit information and memories, they may feel less isolated from one another. Humans need many years to understand the fundamentals, whereas artificial intelligence can be trained on millions of articles in just a few days. Elon Musk pointed out that if it had taken 10% longer for consciousness to arise, it would never have arisen at all. And Nick Bostrom has shown how AI could help colonize the galaxy, creating billions of wonderful lives. But he also points to something far more important. We will just make it more determined to get rid of us if we try, as it will always outsmart us. We are like children playing with a bomb, according to Nick Bostrom. This is the worst risk. However, scientists disagree that AIs will put an end to humanity or greatly improve and lengthen our lives. In either case, tiny robots might play a part. Nanorobots are being developed to combat sickness and aging, but we won't be able to produce them until atomically precise manufacturing is made possible by AI. American inventor and futurist Ray Kurzweil predicts that before the end of the decade, we will have this technology and stop aging. Additionally, according to Kurzweil, we are about to enter an era of exceptional abundance, defined by snap-together homes, cheap renewable energy, 3D printing clothing, and food from vertical agriculture. But Kurzweil also stresses the enormous danger posed by AI. Because AI will impact our future and we should be influencing it, experts are calling attention to its rapid development. Elon Musk says that it scares the hell out of him and the rate of improvement is exponential. If humanity collectively decides that creating digital superintelligence is the right move, we should do so very carefully. To keep up with their intellect and keep them from becoming too powerful, we should make sure we always have a way to understand them. Do I believe we are currently at our greatest risk? Yes, we are developing increasingly strong and autonomous technologies, but we aren't doing enough to make sure that they'll be put to good use. Elon Musk also said that the percentage of intelligence that is not human is increasing. We will represent a very small percentage of human intelligence. There is a lot of discussion on how human intellect will eventually be surpassed by robots, as well as how human intelligence will continue to develop and grow. It is also possible that machines will one day surpass human intelligence and render us obsolete. Self-replicating nanorobots are difficult to defend against. As Nick Bostrom says, they might mass-produce themselves without our knowledge. DeepMind is alarmingly close to achieving AGI, according to Dr. Alan Thompson. Although there is no agreement on this, he offered a fascinating IQ scoreboard showing how AI is beginning to surpass us on our own tests. A variety of tests have been developed by Google and DeepMind to determine when AI is more intelligent than humans in various domains. But even if AI appears to be human, how will we know whether it is truly conscious? The patterns that give us rise to consciousness are being identified with increasing success. For instance, by observing the brain activity of unresponsive patients, scientists are beginning to identify awareness. A small set of rules on how to wire our brains are contained in human DNA. Our DNA can construct brains through emergence but does not have enough information to characterize them. Scientists are currently investigating whether the entire universe is an emergent phenomenon. Many experts have asserted that an AI breakthrough is not necessary. The neural networks only need to be scaled up for super intelligence to appear. According to Max Tegmark, there might be a time when AI is intelligent enough to comprehend mankind, but not so intelligent that it doesn't care. Our greatest risk and opportunity are what is emerging, and we are all influencing it. While AI is advancing quickly, the human brain has not expanded in 300,000 years. Therefore, when AI develops, it may significantly outperform humanity.